No one more than a medical malpractice plaintiff side lawyer knows how important it is that we have skilled individuals doing these types of practices, right? But we're not in normal times right now.
A retired nurse can't sit back and watch the fourth wave crash through Alberta. Now she's seeing if she can get back into the field to help out as health officials call on retired doctors and nurses to step in.
They know how to do that. They'll call down the list in terms of, you know, the people that are just retired who have those skills, and then the people who are just outside of that who have the skills, and down and down and down until they would get to someone like me.
Comfort was a nurse in 2011 and 2012. She took her medical skills into the legal field and is now a personal injury and medical malpractice lawyer. On Wednesday, she tweeted this. She tells me she posted this tweet as a concerned citizen who wants to help not only patients, but to relieve some stress from old coworkers still in the field. Now, to be a registered nurse, you have to consistently complete so many hours of work. Comfort hasn't been a nurse since 2012, but she says that under the Public Health Act, there's a provision that allows the Minister of Health or health regions to make exceptions to extend capacity potentially beyond registered members.
If those types of exemptions or, you know, the call was made, I feel that I would probably be better suited to kind of fill in from the bottom and relieve people who may be able to go up. So things like maybe a less acute nursing ward where there are nurses who could be used in the ICU or critical care settings, or who could be trained where their skills are more up to date. I have a lot of experience with IM intramuscular injections. So can I relieve a nurse who's doing immunization so that they can go help.
In a statement to City News, the College and Association of Registered Nurses says in part, employers have identified qualified individuals for us, and if all requirements are met by the applicant, their permits are approved within 2 to 3 business days. There are a few types of permits individuals have received during the pandemic, including a permit only for vaccine administration, courtesy permit, and emergency permit for COVID-19 response. Comfort has reached out to Karna in hopes that they might be able to identify an area for her to use her old skills in this public health crisis. In Calgary, Christy Kilburn, City News.